I'm going to talk about this new hub that we did during the last year. Essentially, what we have is that we took the XML and then we modified and improved the transformation XSLT, and we got HTML basic. Okay, and with the help of CSS and JavaScript, we have improved quite a lot the user experience of the help. And the idea is to continue to develop this new help with more resources and more improvements in terms of web technology of today. I don't know if you are aware, but the help system that we had in the past was designed in 2003 or 2004. It was deployed in 2005. And at that time, the browser war was raging. It was a fight between Internet Explorer, Mozilla, and other technologies, and there was not very much standardization. So possibly, and some ecosystem at the time decided to be independent of the browser and then design a specific XML content to display at the time of the schools. What we have now is that we can use the modern technology, and with this modern technology, the user experience is much better. I'm going to show some of these features, and at the end, I will show also the work we are doing with Mike to get an editor, online editor for the help pages. So we use CSS to make some menus, drop-down lists. We use CSS also for selecting contents of the help. I'm going to show you for live. We use JavaScript and CSS to copy contents immediately to the clipboard. So now, for example, if you hover some of the examples in the formulas of calc and math, you can copy with one click in the clipboard and paste in your documents. So this is a working by example that we are doing. And also use JavaScript to implement a fuzzy search on the keywords of the help. Translators know these keywords because it's the bookmark value tag that you often see while translating with Pluto. We also did a small trick. If you hover icons in the help, you will see it enlarged, because sometimes the icon is a little bit too small. And we are switching the the icons from PNG to SVG, so in the browser it will render much better. These are small improvements, but there is room for many other things. Okay. We also now can implement videos and audio multimedia content in the help pages, especially the online one. The offline one is not implemented because of some legal issues with some countries. But online, you can have and implement multimedia. You can implement multimedia in your pages. This multimedia is something that we would like that the community multimedia is something that we expect the community to provide to us. Okay. we can give guidelines, but if you have a specific multimedia that fits in the needs that, of the help pages, then we can use it instead. And also, we implemented the object tag, which means that now some pages you can have a file that you can download and then exercise the content of the help page. For example, if you are talking about pivot charts and you are having trouble with the pivot chart, you have the pages, but you can also now download a file with the pivot chart and start working on it. Okay? Very well. Let me show you a bit how it works. Let's open my browser. This is the page that we have so at the moment. Here we have the index that you can use to search the keywords that you want. So if I type here pivot, I will have a set of links for pivot charts or pivot tables pages. And here, up on the left, so since the screen is reduced, it has been
in the online help. So if you are talking, if you need
need support for pivot charts. You can model the file and start working with the pivot charts and the pivot table and exercise yourself with the contents of the file. Okay? We also would like to encourage the community to provide animated GIFs so that we can show some of the movements of the mouse and the menu or toolbars, and then make the graph much more rich for the user. The idea is to put yourself in the place of the user. Okay? When user comes to the help, user has a problem. And we would like to make it the most smooth possible for the user. Then that's why we are investing in terms of resources and technology to assist the user and make his life much better. Okay? We are not here just to pay for technology. We are definitely trying to look in the point of view of the user. Okay? We will also, next year, implement some accessibility tools. For example, this specification from W3C means that we need to provide a label that can be read by SST technology. And this label can transform an image into something readable for the visually impaired people. Okay? And this will require a full-house reading of the help and changes a lot of the content and with reflection to translation. So translators, please get ready because the help is going to change a lot. Okay? Very well. That's the presentation, and now I want to show you what we did, Mike and me, in terms of implementing a way to for help people to edit the help pages. Okay?
Ask me this confirmation, and then it's
serves all this XML that it needs. So first line is standard in terms of XML, the license, then it's meta content. I have some placeholders that I left to remind the user to type the correct content. The title, the file name, and this is the standard beginning of a file on the help content. Okay? And I have the opening body and the closing body and the closing help content also. So everything will go inside these things. And then, for example, I may want to here in line 19, I may want to insert, for example, a document heading, and it suggests a set of text that will be inserted into the content and a specific ID for the section. Then these paragraphs and bookmarks get an automatic identification, the ID, and this ID is unique, which whoever has already worked on XML for help knows how cumbersome it is to define this ID because they need to be unique. Okay? So everything is much as a template for you, and you can immediately start inserting the content. Okay? We have many other implementation. For example, if I want to insert a table, I can type here table full and all the tags for a table are inserted as the placeholders, and then we just start typing for the content. So it's a lot of shortcuts in terms of typing, and with a little bit of a learning curve, you quickly get used to it. The idea is to get this editor available in Garrett, so that when you save the file that you have created or edited, then it will generate a patch in Garrett so that it can be reviewed by a peer.
And maybe I can also show as well the auto completion.
Yes.
So if we, how do we delete anything? Okay, so we are here with a completely empty document. If I type a left angular bracket, it says here help document as the master top level tag. So we say, yep, help document, space, and then it gives us an option to auto complete an attribute version. So yeah, equals 1.0, fine. And now it indents automatically, and we can say, so meta and body are both child tags for this, so we can say the string is body, and then it shows us what are child tags of body, so section, paragraph, table, and so on and so forth. Or we can, there's a forward slash keyboard. There we go. So we can close as well. So forth. So just a little bit of a time saver, but it also shows which types that show child tags of other types. I don't know how to describe it, but
child tags. So applause for Mike for doing all this stuff, choosing Code Mirror. And next step is to integrate this editor. We will of course improve this layout. This layout is just there for proof of concept. We will make Garrett. So the change will be immediately available for revision. Okay? Well, thank you for your time. If you have questions, please go ahead. And it's a short presentation, but nevertheless, there is a lot of content. And especially what I would like really to invite the community is to contribute in terms of not only the multimedia, but also cultural content, and even ideas that we